Today's show is brought to you by Audible. Get a free audiobook download and a 30-day free trial at audibletrial.com/themariahreport. Over 180,000 titles to choose from for your iPhone, Android, Kindle, or MP3 player. Hi.
Oh, wait. Yes. Here we are. I don't know when we're starting now sometimes. Are we starting?
Yeah, we're starting.
Oh, this is it.
Yeah.
This is the rainbow back in time already. Here we are.
The rainbow tour.
Oh, yes. Yes. Because we couldn't get enough rainbow. Oh, let's just... Dan Martin.
Hi.
You guys, you're listening. You know us.
This capped off the rainbow era. This was the end.
It really was.
Yeah.
It really was. She's sort of like... swang it on home mm-hmm. with this great tour.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was mainly a US tour, even though we got a little Europe and a little of Japan in there and a few other places, I think.
Japan and Singapore.
And Singapore. That was the first time she performed in Singapore, actually.
And when I was deep in the Lamb world now by this stage.
Yes. So you were like out. Really like living it.
Here's a year later. I'm like deep. I've already gone back to all the butterfly and dug it all up by now.
Uh-huh.
There was rumors she was coming to Australia with the tour.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't recall those.
Mm-hmm. Because at the time I worked in the record store, remember?
So you had the inside track.
The connection. And so like one of our guys from head office, one of the head buyers, was telling me, he was like, she's coming. I'm like, what? He's like, yeah, if she comes, you can come with me to the meet and greets. Because remember back in the day you had to do meet and greets and
yeah,
the press
yeah,
things,
yeah.
All that kind of shit. He's like, you can come. I remember just like losing my mind.
You were like,
oh my God.
Freaked out. Okay, so wait, this was like the first. Okay, what was the first Mariah concert you went to?
Charm Bracelet.
In New York here, right?
Yeah, came all the way to New York.
Oh, wow. Mm-hmm. Well, here's the thing. Rainbow was my first Mariah Carey concert ever. However, I had seen her live once before. She did a little radio show where she did One Sweet Day with Boys to Men in Chicago.
Mm.
She was just a special guest for that one song. So I saw her there, but this was my first concert.
Mm-hmm.
Living my little gay boy life.
I wanted to go so bad.
Yeah.
But here's the thing. I never planned to go anywhere because I kept hearing rumors she's coming to Australia.
Yeah.
So it was too late.
Yeah, but then it's like, okay, well, she's not coming, so now I got to go to her.
But it was too late. It was like, I couldn't.
Well, yeah, because you already thought it was happening. Yeah. But that's when Charm Bracelet came.
Then
you were not missing your opportunity.
No, I knew. I learned my lesson.
You knew. She's not tricking me.
Well, I think the problem was at the time, the economy, the Australian dollar, I remember in that time, was like $1 was 50 cents US. So she would have made no money, probably lost money.
Okay.
Or tickets would have been a gazillion dollars and she wouldn't have sold it.
Oh, I see.
Like it was a.
I see.
It would have been
Those types of things, Martin, never crossed my mind.
Well, nobody was coming anyway. Like no big acts were coming in that era.
Oh, okay.
Altogether.
But she had done Australia in the Butterfly in 98.
Tour. Yeah.
See, because that's what I always think. Like, when Mariah did the Butterfly show in Hawaii, I was like, oh my God, I'm finally going to get to see Mariah.
Mm.
And then she never came with that.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I sort of did what you did, but I was one era ahead.
Uh-huh.
I was like, I'm going to the Rainbow show, come hell or high water.
Yeah.
So I went by myself. I bought myself a ticket. These are the days where I went and stood in line
at
the Ticketmaster outlet, which was in the grocery store, and I waited in line. Yes, and I got my one ticket. I went up there. I said, here's my money, one ticket.
Yeah.
I knew nothing about anything, and I think I paid $115 for that show in 2000. $115.
I just remembered something. So I'm in the record store. I'm a little gay, baby gay, loving being a lamb.
Yes.
A newly formed lamb. And in our store, we were in the international airport at Sydney. They were proposing, because we had other stores around the city, they're proposing that we get a ticket tech machine. I think it's called ticket tech.
Oh, okay.
And nobody wanted it. But I'm like, I want it. I want the machine.
Yes, I want it because I'm going to need my Mariah ticket.
Yes.
I'm voting yes. Yay, yay, yay.
I'm not kidding. We had a big meeting for our store at the airport with all the staff. And our manager was like, who wants it? And I was the only one with my hand up. Nobody wanted to deal with it.
No.
There's like so much more work to deal with it.
Oh, there's so much. Of course. And then you have like lines lining
all
up. People
that,
and
all
you know,
night
like,
long.
Oh,
all
of
that
course.
Shit. But I was the only one that was like, I want the machine.
So did you guys get the machine? No.
We never got it.
Damn.
But she never came anyway, so it doesn't matter.
Exactly. When was the next time she came? Was just the other year. Right? Because she didn't come with Mimi. She didn't come with...
not Mimi.
No, it was the triumphant tour.
Triumphant
was
tour.
Was her triumphant return to the Australia.
Australia, yeah, exactly.
Look how many years that was. So that ticket machine would have never given you anything.
No.
Damn it.
Exactly.
It's all right.
Well, I'm glad we didn't get it.
Yeah.
It would have been a headache for no reason.
And everyone would have hated you.
Exactly.
And like nobody get anything good out of it.
Yeah.
Anyways. So the Rainbow Tour, again, we just did our Rainbow Saga episodes, and this is like wrapping that up because this tour is one of Charm Bracelet, I think, is my favorite tour, but then Mimi, and then this one is right behind it, maybe a close second.
The bummer about it is that it was never professionally released.
Exactly. It was recorded.
It was
Charm Bracelet was recorded as well.
But it wasn't released as well.
No, never released. So it's really, it's, you know, when you go back in time with this, you have to like, I luckily was able to personally experience it, but I don't think a lot of people who are lambs nowadays would.
Mm-hmm.
So like you might be forgetting or not knowing what was going on at the Rainbow Tour, but girl, that was a cute tour.
Mm-hmm.
It was super cute.
Because I did an album, I decided to do it, you know, okay, let's make an album because I had a single ready for the movie, but the movie got pushed back. So then I said, let's do a world tour over Christmas. And everybody was like, you're out of your mind. There's no way you're gonna pull it together. And it's been really fun. And it's a different approach to touring. It's a different thing. It's almost like a Broadway show kind of thing. But it's pretty cool. Maybe vaudeville, I should say. And this show is going to be very different than anything I've ever done. One major difference about this show is going to be that Bianca is hosting it. And in case anybody out there doesn't know who Bianca is, she's the evil girl in the Heartbreaker video. And she also happens to be me, my evil twin.
Looking at it now, you can see it's kind of, like you were telling me, it's an extension of the Butterfly Tour.
Yeah.
A few recycled moments, maybe.
Well, because she intended for the Butterfly Tour to come to the U.S. And she got offered this movie deal with Chris Tucker, and then he dropped out at the last minute, so she scrapped the Butterfly Tour. So if we had gotten a Butterfly Tour in the U.S., we probably would have never gotten a Rainbow Tour. Does that make sense? You know what I mean? Because she would have toured it in 1998.
Yeah, too close.
And it would have she would not have come right back of like making an album and then going right back into a tour.
Yeah.
So these are all the things, like when Mariah talks about how long it took to make the movie Glitter, all of these things, the Chris Tucker movie, the Rainbow Tour, the Rainbow Album, all of those things,
the tour,
all sort of like pushed it back, pushed it back, pushed it back. That's why when we got it in 2001.
Glitter,
yes.
And this tour is 2000.
Yeah, it started in February of 2000.
Right after this was the Glitter making.
Yeah, yeah, it was. So she was out promoting, like if you watch the Rosie O'Donnell show where she performed Petals, she was promoting Thank God I Found You as the lead or the second single, which ended up going number one. But she, in a lot of press interviews, she was talking about this tour and how excited she was to perform Thank God I Found You live for the fans. So that was like sort of like a highlight. Like that during the tour that we got.
First show of this entire tour here in Belgium. What's up in the back? Let me see you in the back. Hello. I would give up everything before I separate myself from you. After so much suffering, I finally found unvarnished joy.
Can we start at the beginning of the set list.
Yeah, because
it's a great set list.
Well, like, we look back at the set list, Dan and I, and we were saying, this could be, switch out a few things, this could be the Lamb Tour.
Yeah,
it's
absolutely
a really, really good set list.
You know, it really is. Should we just run down the set list, or should we go, like, piece by piece?
Let's run it down so they can get a full visual of it.
And then we'll dive in.
So but keep in mind, like, imagine what you want the Lamb Tour to be. That's never,
right.
never going to happen. It might have already happened. We missed it. So it opens with the Rainbow / Petals video introduction.
So I think that was just like
the instrumental, right?
It was like an instrumental opening. and the video introduction was just like rain and lights.
Lightning.
Yeah, and lightning, like, you know, the storm.
She opens with Emotions, which is like the butterfly. There's a butterfly opening.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
She has My All, Dream Lover, Ex-Girlfriend.
Love it.
Vulnerability.
Love it.
Against All Odds.
Love it.
Without You.
Saves that for like Europe.
Yeah. Asia.
And Asia. Yeah. So that was a big one.
Make It Happen.
One of my favorites.
Thank God I Found You.
Mm-hmm. With Trey Lorenz.
Yep.
Was doing the male vocal. Yep.
Fantasy. Recycled choreo from
Same. Yeah.
Butterfly.
Mm-hmm.
The Around the World DVD.
Yep.
Sorry.
Always Be My Baby.
Always Be My Baby. Cry Baby.
Close
my
eyes.
Into Petals.
Into Petals.
That's a Lamb moment,
like,
right
if
there.
That is not a big Lamb moment right there.
Yeah.
And wait, because then it's followed up with Can't Take That Away.
I know.
Girl, those three songs, boom, boom, boom.
Yeah.
Unbelievable. Like, that is the moment that, like,
Cry Baby into Close My Eyes.
Yeah. That little section right there,
that's
Cry Baby,
it.
Close My Eyes,
that's
Petals,
the Lamb
Can't
tour.
Take That.
That's the
if
Lamb
she
tour.
Were to do that right there,
yeah.
That's all I need.
Uh-huh.
Do you do those songs? That's the whole show right there.
I know.
That's all I need.
Yeah.
I'm leaving happy. I am leaving happy. All it takes is just going back in time, reliving it, you will so be in love with it all over again.
Oh, when we were talking about Vision of Love, I like talked myself into it.
I'm like, now you're like, oh, shit.
The good song. I like this song. Yeah,
I'm telling you, that's why we do these back in times, because like reliving Mariah's past career is literally the best thing. Because her music, her career, everything, blah blah blah. But anyway, so Honey, Vision of Love. Then Rainbow Interlude, which was essentially like the closing of the show. And then she came out and did like a
encore
with Hero and the Butterfly Outro, which is what she normally does, the Butterfly Outro.
Strong set list.
Very strong set list.
Yeah.
I mean, just for those four or five songs we just talked about.
Yeah.
Could you imagine her doing that today? That would be iconic.
Flip out.
That's why this set list was really great.
This is such a good set list.
Such a good set list. Right off the bat, it's a very subtle opening. So when she opens the show, she does a couple of like vignettes, like little like clips of movies. Her and Bianca, the comparison, like, oh, favorite color, Mariah, pink, Bianca, black. You know, whatever they were. Favorite animal, lamb, Bianca, a scorpion, you know, blah, blah, blah. So like that. So super cute.
Building Bianca's character.
Building the character, introducing people really fully to who Bianca is. Because we saw her in Heartbreaker, but now Mariah's like bringing it. And I like that.
Yeah.
For that. You know what I mean?
Right.
I thought it was really good. So she comes up from the bottom of the stage.
Well, wait, I didn't realize this until we just watched the video. There's like a sheet silhouette situation happening.
Right.
There's a fake Mariah going down the stage.
Right.
I never realized this. And then the real Mariah pops up instantly in the front.
Right.
So you think she's over there, but now she's over here.
Exactly. Yeah. I know. I don't think people really realize the intro for the Rainbow Tour.
No, because you see pictures and it's just her coming up.
It's just her coming up. There. But really it was, because remember, like we had the lightning and the rain and we had like this drapey drape. And so there was a video with the lightning and rain. Mm-hmm. And then there was a silhouette of a quote Mariah.
But it was a
and
real
everyone
person.
everyone thought it was Mariah, but it really wasn't Mariah.
Cuz if you go to YouTube and YouTube it, the Rainbow Tour, there's someone filmed it in Chicago with their camcorder from the top of the stadium or whatever it is, the arena. So it's all wobbly and
they
shaky.
They smuggled it in.
But you see this weird situation where there's like a wig. You can see the wig.
Yes,
back
there. That was a wig, girl. That was a bad wig.
On but the again, decoy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because when I saw it, I was like, what's happening?
Yes. And then Mariah comes up in the front of the stage from below and everyone goes crazy. And it's just Mariah just standing there like, hey, guys, what's up? And then she goes right into emotions. Vocals are great.
Now you were
on
there.
This tour. I was there, yes.
What was going through your mind?
Okay, first of all, I was gagging.
Where were you?
In Chicago, it was at the United Center. I was at the far end of the floor. So I was just high enough to look over the floor. So like all the sections that were down. And I was, you know, I was maybe sixth or seventh row. So about 6 or 7 feet from the ground. But I was at the best, so I saw the whole view of the stage. So it was for me, and never being to a Mariah show or any, I think the only concert I had been to prior to that was Janet Jackson's Velvet Rope tour, which mesmerized me. I was like, this is amazing. I was fully living my best life. Oh, I could not have asked for anything better. It was the perfect introduction to a Mariah show for me.
Yeah.
Yeah. I could not have been happier. Everything. And I got that really great picture of Mariah coming out in the Heartbreaker gloves. Honey, that right there was like, this is so worth it. Mm-hmm. Like, Mariah just looked dead in my eyes as I shoved a camera in her face in the middle of the audience. Because what Mariah was doing, she was going through the audience a lot. Like, with Heartbreaker, she came out. And then even with Hero, she would sometimes go out into the audience. Like, we saw her do in the Butterfly Tour. She mm-hmm. would go out and sing it in the audience, mm-hmm. You know, and shake hands and do all of that. So I was just loving it. That's all I know.
Oh, shoot. I just had a question. And
oh, no. What was it about?
Mariah, the audience, camera. Oh, had you met her at the city? You had met her.
Yes,
the
I had met her. I had met her just a few months prior to that. So I met her in November.
Did she give you a look? Like, oh, you?
I don't think she remembered me because I think it all happened really quickly.
Yeah.
And again, like, I was sort of like up. Like, Mariah just saw somebody hanging over the ledge.
With a flash.
And she smiled. Honey, she put her face on and she was like, here, I'm ready. You know, she sees a camera. Okay. And it was one of those cameras, like those disposable Click. Cameras.
Yeah.
And you had to like wind it up. You had to wind it up. And click, wind it up. Yeah, remember that?
Those
yeah, that's
days,
what I took yeah. it on. I took it on a disposable camera. It's one of my favorite pictures, though, because it's just so good. I just remember having a lot of fun. Look how old we are.
I'm just imagining you at the Mariah concert with your disposable
yes,
camera.
Yes, I was clicking.
Taking and pictures.
clicking and twisting.
Was it the Kodak yellow one?
Yes, it was. Let me tell you what else it was. This, because you know, we were in the new millennium now.
Yeah.
So now you could do panoramic shots.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yes, girl, you get the panoramic. And you know, I had the great view because I saw the whole stage. I was getting my panoramics that were like, and then I got the pictures developed. And
they're
the pictures
really long,
were like a foot and a half long. And I'm like, what am I going to do with this? Oh, here, let me like bring this to school and show all my friends. Hey, I have a foot and a long, half foot and a half long picture for you from the Mariah show. Hysterical. But I sure did it. Yeah, I have those foot and a half long pictures in my book bag. Yes, I did. Yes, I did. Mari, you're making me laugh too much.
Oh my God, those days were crazy.
Oh, it's technology.
Look at the poor guy on YouTube.
Yes, he had to smuggle it. You could tell.
But he had to look through the little hole to find her.
Yes, he's like, where's she at? Where's she at?
He can't find her.
Oh, man. But here's why I am so upset that this Rainbow Tour is not released on DVD. Ooh, I got to calm down. I'm sweating from laughter. Because I think there were great vocal moments that we will never capture. Martin, you cannot stop laughing. I don't get it. Oh, those were the days. That's what you did. Everybody was doing it. I wasn't the only one. But I do remember. Oh, my God. I remember getting those pictures. They had to put them in a long folder. Like, it was hysterical. Looking back at it now, hysterical.
Oh, gosh.
I do remember one of those panoramic shots was beautiful because she was in the pink dress, which I think she performed, like, Can't Take That Away and all of those. Because her outfits actually changed a lot during this tour.
Mm-hmm.
But in Chicago, she wore this beautiful pink dress with, like, an open in the middle between the breasts, and I loved it. And there was one panoramic shot, which I don't have, so I can't show it to you, but I remember it being one of my favorites because it was like, it just looked beautiful, the mm-hmm. stage and the lighting and Mariah like in the striking pink gown. Even from far away, from the other side of the thing, it just looked great. It was visually great.
Now that I'm remembering it, I ordered a VHS off eBay of the Toronto show.
Oh, yes, yes.
Same situation, but way up there.
Way up there.
Wiggling around trying to find Mariah.
Yeah, I think there are a couple of you can all YouTube this, you know, whatever. Allegedly, everything is there.
Mm-hmm.
From Toronto, which was professionally filmed because it was supposed to be a DVD.
And in the bootleg one I saw, you can see the big cameras all over the place.
Yeah. And Chicago was bootlegged. And then I think San Jose was also bootlegged.
Oh.
Yeah.
But I remember just now, thinking, she's changing a lot.
Yeah, she did a lot.
Like almost every song or every other song.
Yeah, pretty much. She did like maybe two or three songs and then she would change. Mm-hmm. Okay, but let's talk about the ensembles now. What do we like? What do we not like? But there were so many because she started out in Belgium, in Europe, with like that silver dress.
Yes.
It was like a mini dress.
And it had some sort of print on it.
I don't think it had a print on it.
The silver one?
The one she opened up in?
I think it has maybe a butterfly on it.
Maybe. Like, I think it maybe one or two of them had like a butterfly maybe down by the hem. But I don't think it was like printed butterfly. You know what I mean? Because it was a silver sparkly dress.
Whatever. Sparkly butterfly.
But then by the time she got to the U.S. and her first show was at the L.A. Staples Center, she had cut it and she was wearing the cutoff jeans with the silver sparkly top that was like backless, strappy back.
Yes.
And she had her little rainbow tattoo on the back.
Yeah. The dress was like in the vein of Divas Live.
Yeah. Very similar. Very similar. Mm-hmm. Again, this is all the same era.
Of course. Yeah. Where did she get sick? Hang on, we're digressing from
the ensembles because she did have this whole sick thing happening. I think it was
she ate oysters and got food poisoning.
She ate oysters in Atlanta, I believe, because this was after Chicago. Now, I saw Chicago was March 25th. I'll never forget it because I knew it was 2 days before Mariah's anniversary. And I was like, oh, my God, Mariah's going to be in Chicago for her anniversary and I'm going to see her. And oh, my God, my life is amazing. Mm-hmm. And then I think she went to Atlanta. I could be making this up, but from my recollection, then she went to Atlanta. She was eating oysters on her way to Toronto.
Yes.
Got sick.
Uh-huh. Yep.
And then she had to postpone Toronto. But by then, she had already recovered and done Divas Live.
Yeah. Because she joked about it in Divas Live, right?
Yes. During one of, like, when she was at the podium or something.
Yeah.
Yeah, in a pink ensemble with a barrette in her hair. Is going back to that moment. Mm-hmm. So she did. That was, like, the first time, like, Mariah ever canceled anything.
Yeah.
It wasn't even a cancel. It was a postponement because you still got the show and...
I remember seeing videos of it though, and she hobbled out on stage.
Yeah,
you could tell she was still sick.
She must
have got real sick.
Well, it was. Here's the thing: it wasn't just food poisoning; it was severe dehydration as well.
Which comes from food poisoning.
Well, yeah, because you're constantly vomiting everything. So it's like, and girl, that has happened to me. So it takes a minute to come back.
Yeah, I know.
It takes a minute. Like, you can't just be good the next day. Mm-hmm. You know, it takes some time. But for her to sound and perform so amazing after being sick, especially at Divas, which is well documented, yeah, and we can all go back and watch, she pulled it off and she did the damn thing.
Mm-hmm.
So I commend her for that.
Yeah, I remember. I was like in Australia by myself reading Mariah Daily.
Probably Mariah Daily, for sure.
It was something else back then.
I think it may have been called something else prior, but I don't. I think by then it was Mariah Daily. By 2000, I think it was.
No, I think mariahdaily.com website, a fan website, in case you're wondering, switched around Charm Bracelet. Or after Charm Bracelet.
No, because then it became Mariah Daily Journal.
But it still was
Okay,
Mariah
maybe
Daily.
It was Mariah's Diary.
Something, yeah.
I think before Mariah Something. Daily.
Yeah.
And then Mariah's Journal. Something happened. I can't remember. Lambs, I know we have a lot of listeners out there that are Mariah Daily hardcore way back lambs.
Yeah.
Fill us in, because I can't remember.
Yeah, I'm trying to remember the...
But that's where we got everything.
Everything.
We literally got everything from Mariah Daily.
It was up to the date.
It's
literally
still iconic. It's iconic.
Iconic.
I can't
so
even.
Sad it's gone.
So sad.
Yeah.
It's really a shame. Man, they had everything.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, everything. Nowadays, yeah, there are great sites out there. Shout out to Mariah Trends.
Love Mariah Trends.
Love it.
Mm-hmm.
And people like on social media keep us updated. But like, I want it right there.
Yeah.
All in one mariahtrends.com. All in one page.
I remember I was so obsessed with Mariah Daily at one point. I just thought, I'm going to make it the homepage.
Oh, absolutely.
Why am I wasting my time pretending I don't go there first?
Let's not even. That's the first thing. I'm telling you, the only reason I had to go on the internet was for Mariah Daily. Girl, I wasn't doing research for homework assignments.
There was no Facebook or anything.
There wasn't anything. There was no YouTube.
Nothing.
What else would you be doing other than like AOL chats?
Yeah.
And I'm like, bitch, if you ain't talking about Mariah, I ain't talking to you.
Yeah. That's all I went on the internet for, Mariah News.
Yeah, that's it. That's what I used the internet for. Mariah, yeah. And I would download videos.
Yeah, that took like 10 days.
20 days even. And we are tangenting on back in the day.
But it's part of the era.
It is. It is part of the era because you know what's so funny? MTV did a half hour special, a news special on the Rainbow Tour, which is amazing, which you can also on YouTube figure that out. It was MTV News 1515. And there were people on there talking about what we're talking about right now. They're like, we waited in line for tickets and we couldn't get them. So then we had to buy them online.
No, it's like we had to get on the internet.
We had to get on the internet and buy tickets. It's like they couldn't fathom that they
ordeal,
had to do it.
An ordeal.
And it was like, girl, wait 15 years.
Oh, yeah.
And see where your life brings you.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, but in that same special, Mariah is saying, you know, there was more videos for the vignettes that I did in it.
Right.
I don't know what to do with them. Maybe I'll put them on the internet.
I'll put them on the internet for everybody to watch because I had to cut. She had to cut them out of the show.
You can tell the internet's a thing.
It's a thing. Like everybody's like, oh, the internet.
Yeah.
The internet. Their interweb. Whatever. Oh, my God. It's so hysterical looking at that kind of stuff from way back when.
I know.
Hysterical. It's just as it's crazy. Let's go back to some of the ensembles she was wearing.
The ensembles. Yeah, yeah.
Ensembles she was wearing. Like I told you in Chicago, she had that beautiful pink dress, but sometimes she changed it out and she wore other things. But for the finale, she wore something very similar, if not the same exact outfit from when she performed Can't Take That Away on the Blockbuster Awards with the sparkly skirt and just a t-shirt tank top. That was her finale look in a lot of shows. And then there was obviously the cutoff jeans. There was the long tight tube dress that was like sherbet colors.
Yeah, the shoulders out.
Yep.
Like it was long boob tube, maybe?
It was a tube dress, tubular dress. Yeah. Is that what you call it, girls? I don't know. The tube dress. Long tube dress. Then she had like some cute frilly things.
Some of those tube dresses had interesting colors.
Yeah, because they were almost like an ombre or like a fading ombre. Is that it?
Maybe ombre, yeah.
But do you remember that maybe about 2 years ago, Mariah was here in New York in her home on the roof in the hot tub with the kids, and she was wearing one of those dresses. She was in the long tubular dress. I'm telling you, it was the same one from the Rainbow Tour.
Probably.
So she was just, she's still able to fit in it.
I bet her New York closet is the museum.
It has everything. It has all the wardrobes, everything.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
It has a hundred Hello Kitty shirts and all the iconic things from the cutoff jeans to the Sergio Valentes to the fucking tube dress from Rainbow Tour.
Yeah.
Everything. I love it.
I bet it's good.
I know. I would die to look through that closet.
Just have a look.
Icon. Iconic.
I won't steal nothing.
No, what am I going to do with it? I mean, other than frame it and put it on my wall and invite everyone over to look at it. I'm not going to do anything else with it. I would if it was a good piece. I would.
Do you know what? I really want the roof jeans.
Yes. I want the red jacket from the roof.
Oh, that'd be good too.
Yeah. Or just that little slip dress that she was wearing in the limo. Those shots are so beautiful. Let's not get into the butterfly roof because you know we'll go there. You know we'll go there. But I liked the Rainbow Tour ensembles. I really did.
They were all good.
They were good. They worked for it because they were like, they were diva, but yet they were still like really like any girl could wear those things.
Yeah.
You know, they were reasonable and accessible, not over the top.
She could move in them.
She could move in them. Yes, because when she would do Can't Take That Away, she would get down on the knees and she would be running around for Make It Happen and emotions.
Mm-hmm.
They were good. They worked out really, really well.
I mean, I think that's kind of what makes her recent show is kind of boring. She can't move in her dresses.
She doesn't move, yeah.
There's no energy coming from
her. Here's the thing, and they even say in that MTV special, oh, Mariah is always in 6-inch heels.
Yeah.
And yes, she was. But in Rainbow Days, she was moving and grooving, girl.
Mm-hmm.
She was this side, that side, all over the place. She was loving it. Nowadays, she's wearing these heels that are probably 16 inches, but she can't move.
She can't walk
in. So, like, what's the purpose, you know? But that's neither here nor there. But let's talk about the merchandise from the tour, because this is where...
It was good.
It was really good.
And I ordered the tour book off eBay.
Oh, and the tour book was
good.
See
how desperate I was? I was ordering
scraps.
Girl,
you were getting everything you needed, though.
Getting the scraps.
From the internet.
From the internet. Exactly.
Yeah, because eBay was big back then.
It just started.
I would buy things from eBay. I found some good stuff on eBay.
And it's hard to tell what was real and what was not.
Right. But when you did, like, get something real, you were like, oh, my God, my life is made.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So the tour book was great. They had great T-shirts because they had the cartoon Mariah.
They had the lying on the bed with the rainbow in the background.
Yes, they did. They had posters you could buy of the rainbow. They had stuffed lambs.
The lambs.
And this is where, like, the lamb, like... connection was sort of being made as well during this whole era. You could buy a stuffed... Mariah even threw stuffed lambs out into the audience, too.
Like Christmas.
Yeah, exactly.
Get stuff out.
So, I mean, the Lamely has been around forever because, like, just look back. Here we are in 1990... Well, 2000. Mm-hmm. But the lamb's there. Love it.
Calling themselves lambs.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
And even when you watch the Chicago show online, Mariah even mentions those things. She's like, listen, we're going to talk about ensembles. We're going to talk about lambs. We're going to talk about some things. A lot of my hardcore fans love it.
Uh-huh.
Some of you bitches don't know.
Yeah.
And that's on you.
Yeah. But then she says, like, where you guys know it. Everybody knew what she was talking about.
Yeah,
like,
absolutely.
They were all lambs.
Yeah, everybody. Full, sold out, packed arenas.
Yeah.
It was amazing.
Where are they all?
I don't know. They must have had babies or something.
Something's happened.
Something. Or maybe they're raising lambs out on a farm in the middle of nowhere with no Spotify.
Uh-huh. Maybe they don't have the internet.
They don't have the Twitter.
Yeah.
They don't have it.
They never caught onto it.
Okay, so...
But the merch was good.
The merch was good.
But at the same time, we got... we started seeing that you can put Cartoon Mariah on a T-shirt.
Yes.
That was a good
thing.
That
was a good one. I bought the tour book, and I bought one T-shirt. Because, again, I'm poor. I went to the show by myself. I paid $115 for the ticket. I think I drove myself to the place. I had a car. Like, did I have a car? Yes, I did at one point have a car. Believe it or not, I drove. I could not imagine driving nowadays. But
I drive in Sydney. I like driving.
I mean, I've driven a couple of times for necessary things, but girl, I'm like, what? Me behind a wheel?
I like it.
Well, I love jamming out to Mariah while driving. That's what I loved.
Mm-hmm. That was fun.
So I bought the tour book, and I bought the Thank God I Found You T-shirt, the gray T-shirt with the rainbow picture from Thank God I Found. What I had bought, so I loved it, and I wore it all the time. I wore it to school. I was living my Mariah life.
I couldn't get anything. I had to get my rainbow book from tour book from eBay, then go to the mall and get the man to scan the cartoon and make my own shirt and to make my own merch.
Hey, you got to do what you got to do back then. Honey, you got to do what you got to do today, too. She ain't selling no T-shirts.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
But anyways, yeah, it was just all around good era. Mariah gave us great vocal moments. I'm really upset that there isn't more footage from these things because the emotions,
professional stuff, yeah,
her singing emotions kill me.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, can't take that away.
The confidence is there.
It's all there. Mm-hmm. It's all there. The high notes, the powerful vocals. She really sang the hell out of this tour, and we just don't, it's not, because even with Charm Bracelet, the Charm Bracelet tour, we do have a lot of footage, mm-hmm, because people, it was easier to get it then, even 3-4 years post the Rainbow Tour.
Yeah.
Rainbow Tour, you had a panoramic digital, not a digital camera, you had a panoramic reusable camera.
Yeah.
Like crazy.
Uh-huh. The camcorder got smaller so you could sneak it in.
Yes, by the time Charm Bracelet came around.
Exactly, yeah.
Yeah. So, oh man, unfortunately. Mm-hmm. I want, you know what? This is what I want Lamb Homework to be for this back in time. If you took photos from that tour, if you went to that tour and took photos, post them to us.
Tag
we will
us
share
in.
Them. Yeah. We will do it because I think they're great. I do have on my external hard drive over 500 pictures from this tour of professional pictures, fan photos. But like reliving those, I would love to see what the Lambs have in regards to that.
That'd be, fascinating. Yeah. Because back in the day, you didn't think to post it anywhere.
Oh, right.
So you just have them now.
Post it now, please.
It
let's see. Let's relive.
Yeah.
That's what it's all about. I'm telling you, those were good days, Mariah. This was a big tour for her as well.
Mm-hmm.
Now, big in terms of she was doing like 9 U.S. dates and maybe 9 other dates around the world, Europe and in Asia.
Yeah.
That was the biggest she had done. Because even if you look at Daydream was, or even Butterfly, was a total of 8 shows.
Yep.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And so this was big for her.
But it was her first U.S. tour since the Music Box tour.
Correct, which was only about 8 shows.
And
maybe not even.
And completely different Mariahs.
Yeah, completely different. Well, because here's what a lot of critics were saying is, oh my God, Mariah's scandalously dressed.
Yeah.
And she has over-the-top antics, like with Heartbreaker, and she had a boxing ring.
Yeah.
Can we talk about the craziness of the crybaby performance?
Yeah, where she has a bed.
Where she has a bed. Honey, she also has
a
refrigerator.
Yeah.
She has a big teddy bear. She has a pillow on the bed with Luis Miguel's face on it.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
Oh, girl, she was giving the most.
Exactly, yeah.
The most. But I effing loved it.
Oh, of course.
Every second of it. It was so campy.
Kitsch. Campy, yeah.
And just, it worked. Nowadays, when she tries to do those things, it doesn't necessarily work as much,
mm-hmm,
I feel. But we're not talking about nowadays. Back then, loved every second of it.
Yeah.
Fun, crazy, weird, wild, girly, but so loved and lovable.
What about the boxing match with her and Bianca on stage?
Yes, I know. Wasn't that crazy?
Nuts.
That was like, it was like,
it was like, but that was the campiest boxing match ever.
Oh, it was like, oh my God. Like, she would wind up her arm, like a windmill.
Cartoonish.
It was so crazy.
Yeah.
It was so crazy. But DeBrat, and speaking of Heartbreaker, DeBrat was there because she opened up. She was the opening act of the Rainbow Tour.
Yeah.
And then she also, well, at least in Chicago, she was.
I think she did some of them, not all of them.
I think she did some of them, not all of them. Mm-hmm. And then she would do like her remix part,
mm-hmm,
during the live performance of Mariah's show.
Mm-hmm.
I remember that. Yeah, DeBrat. I was excited to see DeBrat because I like DeBrat.
I like DeBrat too.
Yeah. Yeah, she opened for Mariah in Chicago. That's her hometown, so I'm just saying.
Mm-hmm. DeBrat's over there on Dish Nation.
Yes, she is. Yes, she is. Uh-huh. She got a job.
Doing the news.
Oh, she got out of jail and got a job, girl.
Yeah.
I'm not mad at her.
No.
And let me tell you, one time I saw her, I met her live in person. She's very, very pretty.
She looks
She's
great.
She's a very, very pretty woman.
She's very pretty.
Yeah.
I would be friends with DeBrat.
Oh, yes, honey. cool. Then we'll be like, we'll go out drinking and be like drunk texting Mariah.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. Like, to Brett, can I see your phone real quick?
So I love that addition to it. And then when they would do Thank God I Found You, Trey Lorenz mm-hmm. would perform. He would do like Joe's part. And one time I think they did the remix. Mm-hmm. And one show, I could be mistaken, but I think they did. But normally they did like the album version.
I know, it just sucks that we can't get the footage.
It's really,
and watch it.
Really sad. It's saddening, like through and through. Because it's there. It's good. It's got to be good.
It's in the vault.
It's got to be good. If these shows that we see on YouTube right now, which are bootleg, are great.
Yeah.
The professional footage and audio has got to be amazing.
I know.
To die for.
Mm-hmm.
Really. I just don't understand. I don't know what happened and why that never came about.
Yeah.
Lambs, if you out there know why the DVD was scrapped or never released or whatever, please let us know, because I can't remember
happened. It was the days of DVDs being new. So
everyone wanted it. Everyone DVD. Would go out and buy it.
Yeah, everybody wanted a DVD.
Yeah. Man.
Of anything.
Yeah. Yeah, why pretty much.
Why did it get scrapped?
So, all right, let's talk about the ending of the show, because I thought it was always, okay, we got our great little lamb segment mm-hmm. of crybaby.
Petals,
can't take that away.
Close my eyes.
Those were all great performances. Very, very nice. She got emotional during Petals.
Shed a tear.
Yep, she always had a tear come out. I don't know how she made that happen.
Well, I think she was tapping into her acting lessons, because she had a movie coming up soon.
Oh, yes. Yes.
So I think she was pulling in her acting skills.
She's like, I'm going to cry.
Yep.
I'm going to bring the emotion.
Mm-hmm.
You know, at the time I thought it was perfect and great. Looking back at it, I'm like, okay, girl, where'd that tear come from? Because,
mm-hmm.
you know, whatever. But it's still cute. Again, great, great. Loved it. I love the ending of the show. She did the Vision of Love. She did the Hero.
The classics, yeah.
Classics.
And the Butterfly Outro.
Doesn't get any better. And by this time, you know, we opened the show with like the thunder and the rain, mm-hmm. sort of like we were saying with the Rainbow album. By the end of the show, the rainbow had appeared, mm-hmm. the skies on the screen, you know, there's the rainbow, the sun was out, mm-hmm. and so it was all like, you know, and then there was all the confetti coming,
mm-hmm.
It was a great show. Mariah, please release this DVD. I beg of you.
They have to. Drop it on iTunes.
It'll be snatched up in a minute.
Yeah, let the lambs get it.
You don't even have to manufacture the DVD.
No.
You don't have to do packaging. You don't upload. Have to do any of it. Just upload, press send, and sell.
Upload your bootleggy version of it, which is probably amazing.
Yes.
You got the best bootleg out there.
Right. Oh, God, that would be the day. That would be the day. I'm 100% behind this being done. Lambs, every time you meet Mariah from now on, ask her where the Rainbow Tour DVD is.
Protest. Yeah.
Protest and tell her we need it. Anyways, I think, does that wrap up?
I think we covered most of the Rainbow album. If you have a favorite Rainbow tour moment.
Right. Did you go to the Rainbow Tour? Did you see it live? Yeah. Was it your first time? I bet it was a lot of US Lambs' first time seeing her.
Of course.
Yeah. Well, it was mine.
Mm-hmm.
Send us. Let us know. Tag us. Facebook us. Share us. Let's relive the Rainbow Tour.
It was good.
It was so good.
But now I'm traumatized that I can't watch it.
I know. Now I'm mad.
Yeah.
Why am I mad? Because I really want to see it in good quality.
Yeah.
That's why. But anyways, I love it. It holds a place of nostalgia in my life and in my heart.
Yeah, me too.
And
like, there's a story. When it happened, like, yeah, it's a life story connected to it.
Yeah. It was just really good overall.
Mm-hmm.
Anyways, lambs, thanks for listening. Yeah. We love you, appreciate you, and enjoy you. Because
mm-hmm.
Mariah would say that on the tour.
I know, she says that. She doesn't say it no more.
She doesn't say it anymore. But on that tour, I think it was like a line that she said.
Of course.
Well, that's where
it came from.
That's where it came from.
And the voicemails.
Yes. Oh, and she was heavy on the voicemails here, too.
Yeah.
She would leave voicemails talking about, thank God I found you.
On the internet.
On the internet. Yes, she would call the internet.
Yes.
I don't know how you call the internet.
How did she do that?
But Mariah called the internet.
Hey, how did she even do that?
I don't know. Somebody at the record label was making.
She had the phone number for the internet.
Yes, yeah, she had called the internet. Girl, that's like calling Oprah. Yeah. No one has that number. Who's ringing the internet? Mariah. The first.
Could I never heard anybody else call the internet?
No.
With a phone?
Oh, I love it. For the nostalgia.
Because she had to press like a button, remember?
Yes.
Sometimes?
Yeah, she did. It was so crazy. But again, back in those days, the panoramic shots to calling the internet. There you have it. The Rainbow Tour wrapped up.
Okay, we gotta go.
All right, guys. Thanks.
Bye-bye.
Bye.